calculate the molar mass of sodium hydroxide. So the first thing that you're going to do is you're going to list out all of the elements that are present in sodium hydroxide. So you have sodium, oxygen, and hydrogen. Then you'll look to see what the subscripts are for how many of each I have. Sodium, oxygen, and hydrogen all have invisible subscripts, so that means I have one of each. So then I'll go to the periodic table and find each element's mass. So sodium's mass is 22.990. Oxygen's mass is 15.999. And hydrogen's mass is 1.008. One times anything is that thing. And now all I need to do is add all of those up. The number I got was 39.997, and this will have the unit grams of sodium hydroxide for every 1 mole of sodium hydroxide. Then I'll go ahead and flip the molar mass in case I need it in a different direction. How many grams of sodium hydroxide are in a sample of 2.43 times 10 to the 25th particles? You'll notice that my number here is in brackets. That is because my number could be different than yours. However, the steps that I will need to take in order to solve this problem will be the same regardless of what your number is. How many grams of sodium hydroxide will change into X grams sodium hydroxide? R in a sample of is my equal sign, and then 2.43 E25 particles. The E takes the place of the times the 10 and the caret. Currently I'm in particles. The only conversion factor that contains particles is Avogadro's number, so I'm going to go ahead and create the conversion factor utilizing Avogadro's number. So Avogadro's number is 6.022 E23 particles of whatever compound, so sodium hydroxide, for 1 mole of sodium hydroxide. And I'll flip that. Currently, I have particles. I should have written that as particles of sodium hydroxide. Currently, I have particles of sodium hydroxide in the numerator, which means I'll need to choose the version of the Avogadro's number conversion factor that has particles of sodium hydroxide in the denominator. Particles of sodium hydroxide will cancel. I currently have moles of sodium hydroxide, however I asked for grams, so I will need the molar mass for sodium hydroxide, which I have already calculated in a previous problem. Now I just need to choose between the two molar mass conversions that allow me to cancel out moles and get to grams. That will be this left molar mass here. moles of sodium hydroxide will cancel. That will leave me with grams of sodium hydroxide, which was the unit that I said that I wanted. So that means I can go ahead and plug things into my calculator. I'll do that by multiplying everything in the numerator and dividing by everything in the denominator. So I'll have 2.43 E25 times 1 times 39.997 divided by 6.022 E23 and 1. The number I got was 1613.960644. And then on blend, I am asking for 3 decimal places. So I'm going to go ahead and round to 3 decimal places. 6 does make me round up, so this will turn into 1613.961 grams of sodium hydroxide. Given the combustion of butane, create the multiple ratio between butane C4H10 and carbon dioxide CO2. So I'll identify the 2 compounds that were mentioned, visually connect them. Then to create the multiple ratios, I'll take the coefficient in front of butane, which is 2. I'll write the word mole, and then the formula for butane. For every 2 moles of butane, I will have coefficient in front of carbon dioxide, 8 moles of carbon dioxide, and I'll flip that. How many particles of carbon dioxide would be produced from a reaction that consumed 6.31 times 10 to the 15th particles of butane, C4H10, were consumed? So I am going to go ahead and translate this into my math problem. So how many particles will turn into X particles? Carbon dioxide, CO2. Would be produced from a reaction that consumed is my equal sign. And then this number, 6.31 times 10 to the 15th, you'll notice that my 6.31 is in brackets. That's because my number could be different than yours. However, the steps that I'm going to take to solve this problem are going to be the same regardless of what your number is. So that's the number that I'm going to plug in. So 6.31 E15. The E takes the place of the times of 10 and the caret. Particles of butane. Okay, I'm going to notice that I have the unit particles. The only conversion factor that will get rid of particles is the Avogadro's number conversion. So I'm going to go ahead and have to create it for both carbon dioxide and for butane, as both have the unit particles attached. However, it is a defined value. So it is just as simple as just writing it out so that it is easy for me to grab. Okay, I was able to get these because Avogadro's number is 6.022 E23 particles per mole of whatever compound. So I have both versions of the conversion factor for both butane and for carbon dioxide. I need to cancel out particles of butane. So I need the Avogadro's conversion factor, and I need the version that has particles of butane on the bottom. However, I accidentally wrote the same conversion factor twice for butane, so I need to go ahead and fix that real quick. Okay, now I have the appropriate conversion factor available. I'm going to choose this bottom one here. Particles of butane will cancel, leaving me with moles of butane. However, I don't want moles of butane, I want particles of CO2. Since I have two different compounds, I do need the mole-to-mole ratio, since I'm in an appropriate unit here. Moles of butane is currently in the numerator, so that means I need the version of the conversion factor that has moles of butane in the denominator. So that would be this right version here that I already found from a previous problem. Moles of butane will cancel, leaving me with moles of carbon dioxide. However, I don't want moles of carbon dioxide, I want particles of carbon dioxide, so I'll need to use Avogadro's number as a conversion factor to get me out of moles and into particles. I'll need the version that has moles of carbon dioxide in the denominator. Moles of carbon dioxide will cancel, leaving me with particles of carbon dioxide, which was the thing that I said that I wanted. Since I have my appropriate unit, I can go ahead and solve this problem. I'll multiply everything that's in the numerator, so that's 6.31 E15 times 1 times 8 times 6.022 E23 divided by everything in the denominator, so that's 6.022 E23, 2, and 1. Okay, and that gave me the number 2.524. Blend is specifically asking for 3 decimals, so I don't need to round anything. However, when I plug this into Blend, I do need to make sure that it is in an appropriate format. Blend is going to want a lowercase e, a positive sign, since I don't see a negative sign, and then that 16. Blend may change your number into a standard form number. This is okay. It knows the difference. It just wants it to be in standard form whenever you submit. It's fine. Only English left in my math, the thing that I said that I wanted, particles of carbon dioxide.